Okay, another protocol I'd like to talk about is SOAP. Actually, I'm just kidding. We are not going to talk about SOAP. SOAP is based on XML. It's another protocol for communicating between two machines. If you ever have to deal with it, you'll know why that I don't even want to bother teaching it. It's very, very complicated. But what I would like to list for you are a bunch of other common protocols and formats for communicating across the internet. SOAP is one of them. We won't be spending any time on any of these, but lots of people use them. For example, Hipmunk, a lot of our data sources communicate via SOAP. It was invented by Microsoft to make communication online as complicated as possible. We've got protocol buffers, which are from Google. It's similar in concept to JSON. It's a way of encoding different types of data for sending it over the wire. And there's another one called Thrift. This is by Facebook. You've got all sorts of like plain text, custom formats. Now, these are not all. SOAP kind of defines a whole protocol. Protocol buffers are really, how to encode data. Thrift is how to encode data over the wire. These compare more to JSON. SOAP compares more to HTTP plus JSON, kind of the whole package, the protocol and the data type. Of course, you can always just build your own plain text, protocol and data format. But I wouldn't recommend doing this. It's not that hard to just use JSON instead. And then, somebody else who comes along and needs to use their service, whether it's, outside of your company or internally, they don't have to figure out, how to, write all this custom code to parse your custom stuff. Because JSON and Thrift and protocol buffers and SOAP, you can find implementations of these in almost any language. We mentioned XML and JSON. Those are also in this list. Use something that already exists. It'll save everybody a lot of time. I probably wouldn't use SOAP.